welcome to all of you. And I want to thank you on behalf of all our family. Thank you for coming to share these few moments. Share moments to celebrate Mother's life. Share moments that she shared life with us. And that she shared with us, but that she shares it also now. And that she shares it with her eternal family. After Mass, we invite you to share your memories here in the chapel. Your memories of our mother. And after we've shared our memories, we invite you to share lunch in the parish hall, which is, when you leave the chapel here, it's to your right about 30 feet. Emily and them, who you heard playing music as you walked in, Emily is Mother's granddaughter. Ben is her husband. They've been sharing their beautiful musical gifts. And they would like to also now share a special moment and continue to share that gift with us before Mass begins.
We will be starting off with a hymn called Be Still My Soul, and if you look in your programs afterwards, Jody is going to take over the piano, and we're all going to sing the hymn together. But I just want to give you quick background on the song in case you're not familiar. This familiar tune is also used for three other hymns, and the words of the hymn are set to a piece of music called Finlandia, which is a symphonic poem by the Finnish composer Jan Sibelius, which you may have heard of. And besides the hymn, Be Still My Soul, the other three hymns are A Christian Home, This Is My Song, and Ye Rest on Me. And in January 1956, five missionaries sang the last hymn they would ever sing to this tune right before entering the Ecuadorian jungle to bring the gospel to the Aka Indians. And among those five was Jim Elliott. After the men reached the Akas, the Indians murdered them right there on the riverbank. And again, this is the last hymn they were singing as they were murdered. But years later, the story has a happy ending. Contact was reestablished with the Aka Indians, and many of them came to Christ, including the actual killers. And that's how we have the firsthand details of the missionary's death and what they were singing on that day. Some of the lyrics read, Be still my soul, the Lord is on my side. Bear patiently the cross of grief or pain, through thorny ways leads to a joyful end. Grandma sure did have her own share of grief and thorny ways. Her daughter Kathy was born with Down syndrome and died at the young age of 12. Her sister-in-law, which was one of her best friends, as she tells me, Lorraine, was killed in her 40s, I believe, and Grandma was devastated. But the lyrics also read, Be still my soul, the hour is hastening on, when we shall be forever with the Lord, when disappointment, grief, and fear are gone, sorrow forgotten, love's purest joys restored. Be still my soul, when change and tears are past, all safe and blessed we shall meet at last. Grandma is certainly safe and blessed now, in the arms of all her loved ones who went before her.
Thank you. singing number 684.
Kindly stand up. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the Father of mercies, the God of all consolation, be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Hazel died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory.
Please join in singing number 684, Be Still My Soul.
Save. Make this. Read first, second, and third. third reading.
Our first reading is from the book of the prophet Isaiah, chapter 43, verses 1 through 3. Thus says the Lord, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. Through rivers, you shall not be swept away. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, nor will flames consume you. For I, the Lord, am your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our second reading is from the book of Psalms, chapter 62 and 63. O God, my God, how I search for you, how I thirst for you in this parched and weary land where there is no water. How I long to find you, how I wish I could go into your sanctuary to see your strength and glory. For your love and kindness are better to me than life itself. How I praise you. I will bless you as long as I live, lifting up my hands to you in prayer. At last I shall be fully satisfied. I will praise you with great joy. I lie awake at night thinking of you, of how much you have helped me, and how I rejoice through the night beneath the protecting shadow of your wings. I follow close behind you, protected by your strong right arm. I stand silently before the Lord, waiting for him to rescue me. For salvation comes from him alone. Yes, he alone is my rock, my rescuer, defense, and fortress. Why then should I be tense with fear when troubles come? O my people, trust him all the time. Pour out your longings before him, for he can help. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our third reading is from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 4, verses 7 through 8. But we hold this treasure in earthen vessels, that the surpassing power may be of God and not from us. We are afflicted in every way, but not constrained. Perplexed, but not driven to despair. Persecuted, but not abandoned. Struck down, but not destroyed. Always carrying about in the body the dying of Jesus, so that the life of Jesus may also be manifested in our body. For we who live are constantly being given up to death for the sake of Jesus, so that the life of Jesus may be manifested in our mortal flesh. So death is at work in us, but life in you. Since then, we have the same spirit of faith according to what is written. I believe, therefore I spoke. We too believe, and therefore speak, knowing that the one who raised the Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus and place us with you in his presence. Everything indeed is for you, so that the grace bestowed in abundance on more and more people may cause the thanksgiving to overflow for the glory of God. Therefore, we are not discouraged. Rather, although our outer self is wasting away, our inner self is being renewed day by day. For this momentary light affliction is producing for us an eternal weight of glory beyond all comparison, as we look not to what is seen, but to what is unseen. For what is seen is transitory, but what is unseen is eternal. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Can you be seated? Though Father Cantor may not give the homily, yet I think I should, I'm not giving a homily, but yet I think I should love to say a few words, because I saw a great things in this obituary. I didn't know anything about Hazel, other than what Father told me and what I saw of the tables set there.